Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. I am available for code reviews and on-site training. In this episode, I'm going to give you another C++ homework assignment. And this is the one that you probably expected to come along eventually. And that is, of course, constexpr, all the things. I am starting here with the example that I last left off on in our const all of the things episode. So our three homework assignments up to this point will have been auto all the things, const all the things, and constexpr all of the things. You are free to start with your previous homework assignment source code if you would like to. You are also free to start with the small pt example that I have been illustrating from since the beginning of these homework assignments. That is this, the small pt global illumination in 99 lines of C++ code. It generates this image. We'll have a couple of things to talk about in this constexpr all the things episode. But you can see the 99 lines here, and now just a recap, you can go and click on the raw file and copy this and just paste it straight into Compiler Explorer. If you do paste it straight into Compiler Explorer here, I do recommend that, again, we've got C++ 20, pedantic, WAL, WExtra, WConversion, possibly WError. If you do WError straight away, it is not going to compile. You probably want to remove this pragma for OMP, but you don't have to. And you can format this real quick and see that it's actually more like a 145 line program if you want it to actually be readable. We want to constexpr all the things. And for this one, with any project that you're working on, I do suggest that you start from the top. And we're just going to say, okay, can this constructor be constexpr? Yeah, in fact, you know what? It can be constexpr. And we can do that with most of these member functions looking at this particular example. What is going to be very interesting to observe, particularly if you start with the small pt example, is that the more things you make constexpr, the more you can observe the Compiler Explorer window here going from what is currently basically all code to more and more of it becoming data as you make things constexpr. And that holds whether or not you are compiling with optimizations enabled. So if I get to a point where spheres here is a constexpr object that is static, then I can be at O0. And I'm going to see a large pre-calculated data table at the bottom of this binary. So that's something to play with. Now, because we do know, see, this is the set of spheres. We do know the entire geometry of the scene. It is, in fact, entirely possible for this entire program to be executed at compile time and then just to write the PPM out at runtime. That is 100% possible here, but it's going to take work. And to get all the way there is actually going to take a lot of work. And I will give you a little spoiler alert right here. This square root function, go and ask yourself, do you currently have a square root function available to you that is constexpr? That's something you might have to find or implement on your own. And that is just one of the functions that is going to come up when you go to do this. So I didn't really talk a whole lot about constexpr. A constexpr function is a function that can be executed at compile time. A constexpr variable is a value that is probably going to be calculated at compile time. There's some weasel words in the standard there. It doesn't actually have to be calculated at compile time unless it is used at compile time. So if it is unobservable to you whether or not it was calculated at compile time, the compiler is free to not actually calculate a constexpr variable at compile time. But static constexpr variables are always calculated at compile time. So that's why I mentioned this spheres here being static. Now, because it is a global variable, if I make it constexpr, it is naturally going to be static. That is its lifetime, is the lifetime of the program. So that part's already kind of taken care of us here for this thing. This would be a really interesting exercise. Can you get this so that the entire scene is rendered at compile time, and then you just write it out to image.ppm at runtime? And if you're going to have to tweak a few things. You're almost certainly going to have to change the size of the image that's calculated. This number of samples that is done for each pixel, you're going to have to hard code that. That can't be based on the parameters passed in to argv. But once you hard code those things, which is totally allowed in here, then you're going to have to sort out the rest of the things that limit or not our ability to make this entirely compile time. There's some random number generators in here. If you've been watching this show for a while, you will know that there are, in fact, constexpr random number generators. I have written several of them. You can find them in previous episodes and find links hidden throughout my repositories and gists and whatnot on GitHub. So check those out for some help if you want to. I will also tell you that there are, in fact, some constexpr math libraries that are out there. They are relatively easy to find by Googling, and you will probably not be very surprised when you find out who has worked on them. So yeah, that is how constexpr all the things for this example, if you're going to use small pt for this homework exercise, is going to look. If you use your own code, then that is fine as well, of course. But again, have fun with this. If you want to submit your results and share what you have learned, I will put a place in the official C++ Weekly GitHub repository where you can submit your results here as a pull request. So thank you for watching again this episode of C++ Weekly. Make sure you subscribe. The next homework assignment will be coming up in a couple of weeks, and I hope really that you are learning things from these exercises.